Hello viewers, welcome to today's lecture on operating system basics. In lecture 2 of this series for preparation of MCQs on computer awareness for the forthcoming IBPS PU and clerk exams, we had a preliminary coverage on computer software. We learned that the software are primarily of two types, system software and the application softwares. The OS is a vital component of the system software in a computer system. An operating system is a collection of software that manages computer hardware resources and provides common services for the computer programs. An operating system is an interface between the computer user and the computer hardware. An operating system performs the basic task like file management, memory management, process management, handling input and output, and controlling peripheral devices such as printers, hard disks, etc. Let us briefly learn about these functions. Coming to memory management, it refers to management of main memory, जिसे आप primary memory भी कहते हैं. हमने first lecture में जाना था कि RAM, random access memory, computer की main memory होती है. Main memory के feature हैं कि यह fast storage provide करती है और computer CPU यानि सेंट्रल प्रोसेसिंग यूनिट इसे डायरेक्टली एक्सेस करता है. ये बेसिक भी आपने फर्स्ट लेक्चर में वॉन न्यूमैन आर्किटेक्चर में जाना था. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम इस मेन मेमोरी को मैनेज करता है. इट कीप्स ट्रैक ऑफ कि मेमोरी का कितना पोर्शन यूज हो रहा है, कौन सा प्रोसेस इसे यूज कर रहा है. जब प्रोसेस मेमोरी के लिए रिक्वेस्ट भेजता है तब ओएस एलोकेट करता है और प्रोसेस टर्मिनेशन के बाद डी एलोकेट करता है. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम मल्टी प्रोसेसिंग में भी मेमोरी डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करता है. Now coming to the device management. An operating system manages device communication via their respective drivers. What are driver? Driver is a software component of a device which allows the operating system to communicate with the device. आपने आजकल प्लग एंड प्ले का नाम सुना होगा, इसे PNP भी कहते हैं. PNP इज यूज टू डिस्क्राइब कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ हार्डवेयर एंड सॉफ्टवेयर सपोर्ट दैट इनेबल्स कंप्यूटर सिस्टम टू रिकॉग्नाइज एंड अडेप्ट टू हार्डवेयर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन चेंजेस विदाउट और विद वेरी लिटिल इंटरवेंशन ऑफ द यूज़र. जैसे कि आपके आजकल जो USB, माउस, हार्ड ड्राइव्स, फ्लैश ड्राइव्स ये सब आते हैं, दे आर प्लग एंड प्ले टाइप. द मोमेंट यू प्लग इट इनटू योर कंप्यूटर दे आर रेडी फॉर यूज. द हार्डवेयर योर कंप्यूटर सिस्टम इज एबल टू डिटेक्ट दीज डिवाइसेस. एंड कुछ डिवाइसेस होते हैं जैसे कुछ प्रिंटर्स एटसेट्रा हैं जिन्हें आप इंस्टॉल करते हैं और अलग से उनके ड्राइवर्स आपको कंप्यूटर में इंस्टॉल करने पड़ते हैं. Operating system keeps a track of all the devices via its program which is called input output controller. operating system allocates and deallocates the devices to the process. This is device management. Now we come to the processor management. Multi-programming environment mein operating system decide karta hai ki kaun se process ko processor execute karega aur kitne samay ke liye. Is function ko process scheduling bhi kehte hain. Aur process ki jo hum baat kar rahe hain, what is process? Process is a program in execution. It is an active entity. Operating system ka jo program CPU yani aapke processor ko allocate aur deallocate karta hai, ise traffic controller kehte hain. Now coming to its next function on security. Password and other techniques such as biometric access, digital signatures, etc. ke zariye operating system prevents unauthorized access. The next function, error detection. Production of error messages, debugging and error detecting methods. Next function, coordination between the software and the user. Coordination between software and the user via assignment of compilers, interpreters, assemblers and other software to the various users. Now let me explain briefly about the compilers, interpreters and the assemblers. We know computer programs are written in high-level language. Interpreter translates one statement of the program at a time into a machine code. Compiler scans the entire program and translates the whole into machine code. It may take some time. And what is machine code? Zeros and ones form, which the CPU can execute. Assembler converts assembly language to the machine code. Or assembly language kya hai? It is a low level programming language which corresponds to machine language, but here the program can use words. Another function, job accounting. It keeps a track of job and resources used. What is job? Job is a unit of work or the task that the processor is doing. Then coming to the file management. File system mein directories hoti hain, jin mein file store ki jaati hain. OS keeps track of the location and status of this file system. The diagram shows the structure of the OS. Kernel OS ka central part hota hai. Ye most notably computer main memory aur CPU ko manage karta hai. Computer mein mainly दो types के kernel होते हैं. हम इनके ज़्यादा details अभी नहीं जानेंगे. आप ये समझिए कि microkernel, ये जो है microkernel, ये basic functionality रखता है. और दूसरे तरह का kernel होता है monolithic kernel, जिसमें बहुत सारे drivers होते हैं. Then coming to the input-output. Input-output computer system or human ya outer interface ke beech hone wale communication ko manage karta hai. File management system, secondary storage such as disk, tapes, etc. mein storage ko manage karta hai. And then the user interface is the part of the OS that users use to input and receive data. ये ग्राफिक यूजर इंटरफेस या कमांड लाइन इंटरफेस होता है। अ कंप्यूटर इज अ मशीन दैट कैन बी इंस्ट्रक्टेड टू कैरी आउट सीक्वेंस ऑफ एरिथमेटिक और लॉजिकल ऑपरेशंस वाया प्रोग्रामिंग। These are used as, that means the computers are used as control systems for various applications such as in kitchen appliances, smartphones, your normal personal computers, industrial processing and automation, supercomputers, networks, etc. We know that operating system acts as interface between the hardware and the user. Depending on the application and in the history of computers वाले जो lecture में हमने जाना था the advancements in technology, we have various types of OS. You can see there are so many types of OSs. Apart from this also we can have some more categories based on the functioning. Let us understand these types one by one. Batch OS. In this case, the user do not interact with the computers directly. Users prepare their jobs offline and submit it to the computer. There is sequential execution of commands and it is easy to manage large works. The earlier computers जब हमारे जो प्रोग्रामर्स थे दे यूज टू राइट देयर प्रोग्राम्स ऑन पंच्ड कार्ड्स एंड पंच्ड टेप्स तब ये बैच ओएसएस यूज होते थे एंड टुडे ऑल्सो दे आर बीइंग यूज्ड इन द पेरोल सिस्टम्स इन द बैंक स्टेटमेंट्स एंड इन द सेटलमेंट ऑफ द ट्रेड्स एटसेट्रा द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम ऑफ दिस टाइप कलेक्ट्स प्रोग्राम्स एंड डेटा टुगेदर इन अ बैच before the processing starts in a computer. A special program called monitor manages the execution of each program in the batch. The multi-programming batch system, the operating system picks up and begins to execute one job at a time from the memory, and when the job needs input-output operation, the operating system switches to another job. In this system, the CPU is always busy. Then coming to the time sharing operating system, it enables many users located at various terminals to use a computer system at the same time. It can also be called multitasking. The time sharing OS is a logical extension of the multi-programming system. Contrary to this, if you see in the batch system, the users do not interact directly with the computer system. In the time sharing OS, the CPU time is shared among the multiple jobs. In multi-programmed batch system, the one which we just saw, the multi-programming batch system, the objective of the OS is to maximize the processor use, and in time-sharing operating system, the objective is to minimize the response time. This gives the advantage of a quick response. Now we come to the multi-processes operating system. In this type of OS, two or more CPUs control the functions of the computer. Each CPU contains a copy of OS, and these copies communicate with one another to coordinate the operations. Each CPU has its own local memory. These load and store instructions in its memory. Then coming to the mobile operating system. Handheld devices have small memory, slow processors, and small display screens and small battery backup. The operating system of this type is designed to deal with these challenges. And you should remember that in the desktop OSs and in the handheld OSs, the CPU or efficiency ke alawa, ease and convenience of the use of the system ko dhyan diya jata hai. Now we come to the real-time OS. In this case, the time interval required to process and respond to the input is very small. This system is used in control systems which require real-time response. Jaise ki example aap dekhe inka applications ka, then it is the scientific experiments, then the industrial control systems, weapon systems, robots, the virtual reality, etc. And these have a dedicated applications depending on the functioning. जहाँ पर time critical decisions लेना बहुत ज़रूरी है, otherwise it can result into a disaster. Coming to the distributed operating system, this uses multiple central processors to serve multiple real-time and time-critical applications and to serve multiple users. These computers communicate with one another through network. The OS runs on different computers in a cluster, and the user at one site can utilize resources of other users for resource-intensive tasks. Therefore, less load is there on the host machine and still the host is able to get a fast processing. Now we come to network operating system. It runs on the server and provides server the capability to manage data, user client, security, applications and networking. It allows sharing of resources like files and devices among the users. जैसे कि आपके LAN में इसकी applicability होती है. Network OSs are Microsoft, आपका Windows Server 2008 है, 12 है, then Mac OS 10 है. It enhances the security implementations in a network and upgrades can be centrally managed. The IBM International Business Machines began producing PCs in 1918. There was a need for an operating system at that time. IBM approached Microsoft. Thereafter, Microsoft offered MS-DOS 1. What does DOS stand for? It is the disk operating system. Thereafter, many versions of MS-DOS were launched, with the latest being MS-DOS 8 in year 2000. These were all the MS-DOS that is were the command line interfaces. The development of the operating system with graphic user interface started in 1980s. However, it was not a separate operating system. Instead, it used MS-DOS as OS. Windows 1 was released in 1985. Windows 1 and 2 were not a success. Then we have Windows 3.1 in 92. We had the 9X series, that is the Windows 95 in 95, and in between we had Windows 98 in 1998. The Windows 98 had integrated internet functionalities added to it. And then the Millennium, that is 2000, was launched in year 2000, which had a focus on multimedia. Windows NT is processor independent multiprocessing and multi-user operating system. Windows NT 3.1, NT here stands for new technology. It was released in 1993, and then the Windows NT 4, it came in 1996 with Windows NT Server and Windows NT Workstation. The NT Workstation was designed for use on both home computers and the workstations. We had Windows XP in 2001, Windows Vista in 2006. In 2009, we had Windows 7. In 2012, we had Windows 8. And then in 2015, we had Windows 10. An operating system enables services for software applications to run a computer. Operating system enables communication between applications such as the MS, Word, Excel, PowerPoint and the hardware. In application softwares go, ye application softwares jaise jo aapki MS, Word, Excel aur PowerPoint etc. hain, inko hum aage cover karenge. Scope rahega features, usability and shortcut keys. Next video we'll see MS Word, which is a document creating and editing software. Thank you viewers for watching this video and join me for the next class.